So when I first met Ryan, I could tell right away that he was a really interesting guy, really smart, really funny and clever. And I was pleasantly surprised to find that he was interested in making music. And I myself love to make music. And so I was like, yes, let's do that together. And then out of nowhere comes this incredible talent. He's a very talented writer, an incredible rapper, and he has all of this great background of music knowledge, and he combines them in this way that is just really remarkable and unique and really entertaining and great to listen to.
I met Ryan's mom, Leslie, who she was aware that I had a multimedia company, hosted a lot of video interviews. I think at the time I was hosting a show called Often Lifestyles. And she pulled me aside. She's like, listen, you've got to come interview my son. He's playing at the Texas Heatwave auto show, and he's a rapper and he's amazing, and you've gotta do it. And so, of course, how could I say no to this mom, you know? And we went, and I was expecting what my image of a rapper was, you know, again, this was like about 11 or 12 years ago. So we get there, and that's when I realized that Ryan was differently abled. And that told me everything I needed to know about this family, because she didn't ever said that. She didn't lead with the Duchenne muscular dystrophy story. She led with the story of his talent, you know? And needless to say, through that process, we've become very close friends. There's nothing cooler than a Ryan's birthday party. It's a huge celebration. Just kind of been walking along with that family on their journey.
Ryan will write about his experiences living with a disability, his social interpersonal experiences. He's written about his family and how pivotal they've been in his development and supporting him as a musician and as a person. And so he's got all these influences about the typical things that you would rap about, but then also he brings in these more personal elements that make his music really special.
He's been pushing the gas pedal since day one. Not to mention Ryan's Day, which is no small undertaking. It's a huge production every year. And he's up for anything, any day, any time. They say that your superpower is found how you meet adversity, you know, how you respond to adversity. And Ryan, I'm pretty sure if we caught him when he wasn't looking and like ripped his shirt open, it would be a big S for Superman, or maybe rather a big W for Wheels, the rapper.
I think Ryan is just an honest and open person generally in his life, but that he really gets a platform to express what he's thinking and what he's going through, his experiences through music. And that's why I think it's such an important part of his life, because it's this great outlet for self-expression and for sharing his message, whatever's on his mind, with his community and his peers and his fans.
Ryan's Day was born out of his love for music. So Ryan's Day is a family-friendly, full-day concert event that, like I said, I think this year is Ryan's Day 12. And I joined them at Ryan's Day 2. So it's become a much larger machine. And when I say machine, the machine's purpose is to raise money for Duchenne muscular dystrophy. And so Ryan's Day, pre-pandemic, was always held at a live music venue, inviting artists from all around Texas. So it would just be this amazing mosh podge of music, food, kids events, you know, face painting, dunk tanks, things like that, games. And the common thread was obviously everybody was there to help support raising money for this terrible disease, but also enjoy yourself just like Ryan does on the ride in the interim. You know, yes, we're here to be warriors for DMD, but there's no reason we can't have fun and stay calm during the whole process.
Hey, Ryan, congratulations. You are so deserving of this award, and I hope that this momentum just takes you like a rocket into future success and more music. Please keep creating. We need you. I love your music. I'm a fan forever. And I just wish you the best and congratulations.
Wheels, baby. Woo! Wheels, baby. Ryan Wheels Schmidt, Spark Award winner, I hear. Well, congratulations, because there's nobody that I feel is more suited for this award more than you. And I feel very honored to have shared some of this journey with you from the early days, recording with Tim Bailey there at Nuff Said Studios here in Austin. And man, over a decade's worth of Ryan's Day fundraisers, all wonderful memories for the books, right? Well, I will say this, that through the years, you've gotten stronger, sharper, and an increasingly more powerful force to be reckoned with. And you amplify everything that's beautiful in this world, Ryan. And I just want to congratulate you from the bottom of my heart. And it wouldn't be a congratulations from Gracie if I didn't give you a big smooch. Congratulations.
Hey, everybody. We're here with Ryan Schmidt, this year's winner of the Art Spark Award.
Yeah.
Sparking creativity all across Austin. With Ryan's amazing music, his amazing lyrics, his beats. And I want to present this award on behalf of all our Spark staff and our board and everyone that's creative in Austin. Ryan's just an amazing legacy of a musician and someone who's doing it, really doing it. Ryan, congratulations.
Well, thank you, Jerry. I really appreciate it. I'm excited and happy to win this award. And shout out to the Art Spark for this and giving me an award that finally, you know, it finally for my talent, I'm being recognized. So just excited to have this award. And I thank y'all. I'd like to thank Rachel. I'd like to thank my dad, like everyone involved, because my dad, he was a musician. So I took after him. So I'm doing rap music. So appreciate to Jermaine Productions too, Grace Sheridan, and my people, my team, the whole Wheels team, and appreciate everybody that, you know, helped me get this award, and it feels good to finally get one after so long.
It's well deserved.
So thank you.
Congrats.